up, folks? This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night. If you are traveling, folks, please be safe. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 24, NASDAQ up 4, S&Ps are flat. Gold contract up $1.60, trading at $1,197 an ounce. Silver up 21 cents at $16.59 an ounce. Platinum up 20 bucks at $1,224 an ounce. Copper down 4.5 pennies at $2.95 a pound. Light sweet crude down $1.79 at $74 a barrel. Bonds are screaming, folks, that the market's going to go south. Bonds, the 10-year is up 10 ticks at 127.04. 30-year is up 28 ticks, almost a full point, at 142.30. King dollar down 251 ticks, trading out at 87.95. You get the euro up 31 at 124.74, and the yen is down 34 at 117.93. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Cash S&P has hit 2074. Right now, you're at 2068. And volume-wise, we're going to come in at, let's see, we're at 387. We're going to come in around 700,000. We go to 700 million, rather. We take a look at the Dow Industrials, up 26 points. The high that was generated on Friday was 894. We've hit 854 thus far. I do expect that baby's going to get hit more than like you'll see it get hit tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be really a slow day. Of course, you get Thanksgiving evening, the eve of Thanksgiving. What you also have, though, is that you have a storm that's coming into the northeast that's going to slow things down on top of that. NASDAQ Composite. Composite hit a price point today of 4474. New highs in the composite. Composite also will come in with a volume of about 1 point. Actually, this is interesting. We're at 1156 on the NASDAQ. So the NASDAQ will actually come in at about 1.665, which is higher than yesterday, which is saying something. It's not saying that. It's still saying it's light volume, but you do have an expansion of volume. Gold contract. We take a look at gold now. It's going to be really wild here, is this, folks. The gold contract is building cause to get through the October 30th downdraft. That number, the specific number on that is 1202. And it's amazing. We hit, well, here, let me get the exact number. So this is bizarre. It's 1202.40. Now, that's when gold on the 31st went from 1202 to 1160 with juice, with volume on the way down. We hit 1202.20 today. The way that we're building cause in this contract is saying we're going to break it and go get up above it and through it. Once you get up above that 1202.40, if in fact we get through there with conviction, you're going to see the price point of 1255 very quickly, and that's where we'll build cause to get up to the July highs of 1341. So there's some real action inside the gold market. We'll do that correlation inside the dollar in a few seconds. We go over to the oil market. So what's encouraging here is this, is that you have oil going south with conviction. We take a look at this oil market. Oil is down 2.3% today. We're at 73.98. Now, the ABC structure on the way down is 70 bucks. What we have with oil out here today is that your last swing low in oil, it was established on the 14th of November. We had volume out there of 152,000, and we're pushing into that with 270,000. There's going to be an OPEC meeting on Thanksgiving, and the way this market is trading right now, guess what? What is specifically telegraphing is that they can have an OPEC meeting all they want, but none of them are going to cut back, or they're not going to cut back enough in oil production, and oil's going to go to 70 bucks. The great encouragement of how the oil market is trading and how the gold market is trading, how the dollar is trading, is this. Is that if we go over to the dollar, we take a look at the dollar, what we've had is this. The dollar index hit a high yesterday. Gold didn't get destroyed. Okay, pull back slightly, had lighter volume. They couldn't destroy the price of gold. We hit 88.51. The 2010 highs in the dollar index is 88.81. So we missed that by 300 ticks. You know, we'll see whether that's it. Now, when you take how the dollar has traded, how gold is traded, how oil is traded, and now we're going to put on top of this is the bonds. The bonds, folks, have been screaming for a long time that they want higher price. The bond market, TYZ, here we go. So the bond market on October 15th has wide price spread, accelerated volume, blows topside. The 10-year traded up to 137.17, okay, which is almost unheard of, meaning in one day, that type of move. Well, what we've done today is this. You have wide price spread again. You have accelerated volume. We've done 2.4 million contracts. And we're at 127.03. The low of the high is 127.07. So what you're doing is you're coming into that low with conviction. That's saying to me, guess what? We're going to get into 127.02. Actually, no, 127.07. And more than likely, we're going to see the 130.17 very quickly. We go over to the 30-year bond, and the 30-year bond has been leading the charge in an extraordinary way. 30-year bond out here today is up almost a full tick. We're up 27, full point rather, we're up 27 ticks. We are trading at 142.29. We have 796,000 contracts. You know what that just did, folks? This is a confirmation, number one, that you have a much higher probability that you're going to get to the high. Why? Because the 30-year is already into the low of the high in the 15th. That was 142.13. We're into that by over 20 ticks. This thing is going. Okay, so now put it all together. When you have a gold contract that won't back off, you have a dollar that hits the highs, you have an oil market that goes south, you have a bonds that refuse to back down on a continual basis and go north. The real question is, when is the S&P going to fall apart? Because we're at highs, you have light volume. Let's go over to the small caps. The small caps haven't tested their high out here yet. Small caps got the Russell 2000 today, got over the swing point from the 13th. It's going to close underneath it. We hit 118.78. We're at 118.25. Bottom line, you know, there's no juice up here. The divergence inside the small caps, meaning you can't even make it to the high, are pretty incredible. Now, I don't think this is going to happen before Thanksgiving, before this week, actually, because tomorrow is going to be really slow. And, you know, I don't see it. Next week, different ball game. Let's go to Tony in Wellesley. Hey, Tony, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
Good. Real good. Listening every day.
Happy Thanksgiving, man.
You too. All the best to you and your family.
Thanks so much. And you also, man.
Yeah, I'm looking at the TZA. I'm buying down at these levels. How high do you think it can go?
Let's take a look. So the TZA, folks, is the direction 300% inverse correlation of the Russell 2000. The low of this year is 1272. That's today. The high is 2058. And, okay, so let's take a look at this. So what we did out here today is that you get to 1272. You're at 1298 right now. And, you know, if you get a failure. I mean, the IWM itself failed. Failed on lighter volume. This also got under the low, did it with lighter volume. I mean, the TCA wants to go to 1772. That's the low of the highs. The high, last high is 1959, and yeah, I can get there. You just gotta, you know how these direction shares and pro shares trade, Tony, okay? They're daily investment vehicles.
Yeah, you don't marry them.
You don't marry them, brother.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Good to hear your voice, Tom.
You too, man. Stay right there. Bye-bye. We're coming right back.